All right, so your thoughts after day one?
Day one was pretty good, very productive. Two in the 400 meter hurdle final, freshman taking second in the long jump. Thought we had a chance to win for a second, but you know, hey, when you've never been there before and coming out for your first time ever and doing that, that's pretty special. Most people in that moment, they kind of fall apart, so I'm really proud of that effort just to fight, but she's just absolutely clueless. This your favorite freshman. She doesn't think, she doesn't overthink, she just does what she's told to the T. And that's a big credit. And Leah, getting all the demons together and then getting in the final for the first time ever.
Uh-huh.
So that's big for her. And then she had to run out of lane eight, which is very difficult. She didn't really see anybody until the last minute. I think had she had a better lane, she probably would have run a lot faster. But you know, tomorrow is just all about scoring. I mean, points in 2 days, it doesn't really matter.
Let's talk a little bit more about Shaquila. Because, mm-hmm. She had sort of a disappointing indoor season, and then even most of the regular season, even into SECs, was disappointing. But then these last two NCAA meets, she's really come on strong. And
yeah, I mean, the approach that I took with Shaquila was that every opportunity for her to screw up was a good opportunity to sort of teach her something. So she sort of had an accelerated learning curve. She's probably screwed up more in that first year on the beginning of the season, enough that by the time she got here, she was experienced. I remember I told her after SECs that this is the best thing that could have happened. She's like, are you insane? It's like, I did terrible. You know, and then the whole point that you have to learn to bounce back from adversity, that's what's going to make you a champion. So her having to go to adversity like that at home in front of all her family, all her uncles, all her cousins, and then having to handle that moment. And I think that's a testament to who Shaquila is. She just took it. She just listened. Okay, great. This is good. I just did with it and came back to regional, really handled herself well. I think sometimes you got to use bad moments to really teach kids how to handle themselves, how to survive, and how to get ready for moments like this. She was unfazed. I mean, if you think about it, she took two jumps, went to the 4x1, and came back, and we moved back 2 feet. I had no idea what the approach was going to do, and still found out where to jump 21 feet. I mean, that's pretty doggone amazing. And I, you know, if you imagine that she doesn't go to the 4x1 and get all her six jump with the same approach, sky's the limit. But nonetheless, I would rather her do what she did there, because we know that we can bounce her around and she can just handle the chaos and still put a smile on her face. So couldn't be more proud of her. And also Leah, you know, this you have a chance to screw up and you don't, that's big. And that's what I told the kids. Now, the kids that are on the borderline for us are beginning to start being competitive and making the final. That's what's the most important. When your superstars do what they do, of course Kenny is Kenny. And she's been on autopilot all year and she did deliver the goods. That's good, but it's more important that the kids that are right on that line make it. And that's the sign of a good team, that if we can come together and finish strong here despite losing Dez, that'll be good for us.
Just one thing going back to Shaquila, is that you took her to NCAA Indoor even though she didn't qualify to run her in the 4x4, sort of to give her the experience. Mm-hmm. Do you think that's like really paid off today?
Mm-hmm. Absolutely. I mean, the goal was for her to be in that environment. And like I told her, the goal was for Shaquila to win the long jump in the NCAA. And all that stuff was basically a stage movie to kind of get her to this point. So when she got here, she was unfazed because she's been in the NCAA and she ran in the NCAA in the 4x4, which is probably not what she's really good at. But she competed there and she kind of overcame that and was part of the sort of the fanfare, the celebration, the hanging out with the NCAA champ, watching the long jump and watching the 4x4, watching Dez do her thing, watching Kenny sort of have a subpar day. And then in the end, when you can take all that stuff in, you realize that, you know what? I belong there. It's no big deal. You know, she had a sort of a bad beginning of the season, a lot of lack of confidence, and Shaquila's sort of an emotional jumper, and we talked a lot about her being herself. And I think sometimes you feel like if you go crazy and start clapping and doing what comes natural, that people will, you know, not like it. And I told her that I was worse than that. They didn't clap, I turned my back to the crowd. So, and her doing her thing, it just relaxes her. This is kind of who she is. She's like that in practice all the time. So just really embracing the fact that Shaquila's just out there. She's just wild and crazy and a great competitor. And sometimes try to be something she's not. And I think she tried to do that from the beginning of the outdoor. Try to be reserved, try to be polite, and the heck with that. We're not going to be polite. We're going to do things right. We're going to be respectful, but we're going to compete. And in the end, if people don't want to beat us, we'll go over.
And how about Caffrey coming to his first NCAA championships, winning his heat, which is sort of, he ran at the front for a pretty long time.
Absolutely good for Caffrey, man. And you got to remember, Caffrey ran one SECs, but didn't make it to NCAA Indoor.
Exactly.
That's kind of a slap in the face, and went to Florida and then ran in the slow heat. So it's kind of guy's been kicked to the side a few times. And every time that happens, I remind him, hey, fuel for the fire. And now he's in a position to do something pretty special and unique, and I think, I mean, then you also got to look at the landscape. There's a lot of big names that didn't make it.
Yep.
So all of a sudden, you remove two or three guys who are running 145, and you start thinking, I got a guy that can kick like anybody else, and is pretty strong as a miler. So I think Kiffer has a legitimate shot to be an NCAA champion. And we just want Kiffer to compete well and do the best he can. Hopefully, he'll come out of this thing on top.
Thank you.